an Aldi.
The Prime Minister's plan for tax cuts, but will it help the households struggling the most? Liz Truss says not all her decisions will be popular, but promises more help for smaller businesses and doesn't rule out extra help for individuals to ease the cost of living crisis.
For businesses that are vulnerable, who don't have the wherewithal to create their own, to invest in their own energy supply, we will be providing support in the longer term.
So tonight, faith leaders in Leicester issue a joint letter appealing for calm after weeks of unrest. What role did social media play in Molly Russell's suicide? An inquest into the teenager's death begins. Another rail strike announced for October on the weekend of the London Marathon and the Tory party conference. Plus, as millions tuned in for the Queen's funeral procession, one man in Windsor's close-up view of history unfolding.
This is the ITV Evening News with Lucrezia Millerini.
Good evening. The Prime Minister has told ITV News she hasn't ruled out further financial help for those suffering the most from the cost of living crisis. Liz Truss also said there would be help for the most vulnerable businesses too, but she insisted she's not afraid to take unpopular decisions such as lifting the cap on bankers' bonuses. Well, it came as the new PM was at the United Nations in New York on her first foreign trip as leader. Well, our deputy political editor, Anushka Astana, joins us now. And Anushka, the Prime Minister in New York at the moment, but her mind must be very much on matters at home.
Absolutely. We've had this period of national mourning where the government has been inactive, but clearly the cost of living crisis has still been there, and that has been the first thing that everyone has wanted to ask Liz Truss about today, and in particular what support is going to be coming for different groups. I asked her about that £2,500 cap for individuals and whether or not there could be more support for the poorest after their additional support runs out this winter, and interestingly she did not rule that out. She suggested perhaps there could be more cost of living payments, for example, in the new year for those at the very bottom of the income scale. But also there is the question of businesses. And I asked her about this. I spoke to a pub owner just a few weeks ago who said he was on his knees. He said today he needed an answer. We have been told there will be a package for businesses for 6 months. I asked her, after that, is he on his own? And this is what she said.
What I can say is that for businesses that are vulnerable, who don't have the wherewithal to create their own, to invest in their own energy supply, we will be providing support in the longer term. And that does include businesses like pubs. The business secretary is conducting a full review of exactly which businesses will be supported. That review will be completed within 3 months. But I can reassure people that own pubs that those are exactly the types of businesses that will get that longer term support.
And so that is quite a big signal there, because we thought that help was going to run out after 6 months. Now she's saying that pubs, for example, will continue to get support after that. We will get more details of that tomorrow. But look, lots of her theories in all of this are really quite controversial, because she says she wants to cut taxes even if it helps the richest most. And perhaps most controversially, she also has suggested, or not denied today, that they are thinking about removing the caps on bankers' bonuses. And I also asked her about that today.
All right, Anushka, thank you. Well, the PM's suggestion of more help for the most vulnerable will be welcomed by those already struggling with soaring bills, but some doubt whether it will be anywhere near enough. Well, Chloe Keady heard from some of the people fearing the future.
Today, government business resumed with Prime Minister Liz Truss flying into New York for the UN General Assembly, meeting world leaders, starting with France's President Emmanuel Macron. But facing questions about a cost of living crisis back home.
Prime Minister, I recently met a pub owner in Yorkshire called Stephen Hay, who told me that energy bills mean that he wakes up frightened and goes to bed frightened. You've talked about support for business for 6 months. Is he on his own after that?
What I can say is that for businesses that are vulnerable, who don't have the wherewithal to create their own, to invest in their own energy supply, we will be providing support in the longer term. And that does include businesses like pubs.
For individuals, there is a £2,500 energy price cap. But what about additional support for the poorest?
So are you going to repeat this winter's support package next year?
Of course, we will continue to assess the situation as we move forward. I understand that people are very, very concerned, and I will want to be providing them with reassurance.
How does uncapping bankers' bonuses help anyone other than bankers?
Well, what the focus of this government is about is increasing growth in the economy. And I'll be looking, and the Chancellor will be looking, at every measure we can take. And, of course, some measures will be unpopular. Of course, there'll be vested interests that oppose them. Of course, it will be difficult.
What vested interests would oppose uncapping bankers' bonuses?
I'm making a general point. It's that the British economy has not been growing fast enough since the financial crisis.
Okay.
And that has a cost to everybody.
You're, in the words of another politician, intensely relaxed about people getting filthy rich.
What I am absolutely focused on is making sure we grow the economy and that our country is successful.
But it is politically risky. It will make you look like you're on the side of the very richest and not some of the people I spoke about earlier.
But we've been in a situation for decades where we've had low growth.
But how can the government borrow lots and cut taxes without reducing public spending?
With a faster growing economy, we can afford to spend on the public services that we all rely on, like the National Health Service, at the same time as enabling people to keep more money in their pockets.
This Prime Minister's mantra is cutting taxes to stimulate growth. Critics say that helps the richest and call it trickle-down economics. By chance today, President Joe Biden tweeted it was an idea he was sick and tired of. Bad timing for Liz Truss. Anoushka Astana, ITV News in New York.
Well, that was obviously Anoushka's conversation with the Prime Minister, Liz Truss. We can now hear from Chloe Keady, who has been talking to some of the most vulnerable, who are worried about struggling and their soaring bills and worried about their future.
I'm dreading winter. I really just don't know what I'm going to do.
Caroline loves spending time in the garden, but when she goes inside her house, she wants to know that she can get warm. As a pensioner, she is entitled to some extra help with her energy bills, but she says it's nowhere near enough.
I got out a calculator, I sat down, worked it out. I'm running on minus about £700 a month. And here am I, wrapping up in a blanket, wondering if I'm going to live through winter.
I cry most days. I cry most days because I'm just frustrated, I'm angry.
Abby's fibromyalgia causes her chronic pain, and she says the rising cost of living is making it worse.
I'm limiting putting my heating on, even though I need heating and regular temperatures kept for my disabilities. It's transport costs, and when you're disabled, you rely on public transport a lot.
The government today said some people with disabilities would be eligible for a one-off payment of £150.
For me personally, that will last 2 weeks. With electricity and food costs, it's just simply not enough.
And just as people are struggling to buy food, those that provide it are having their budgets stretched too. The government has promised 6 months of support for businesses, but they don't know when it will arrive.
We need something done now, really. The energy prices have gone up, ours are going up as well. And then we've got to go and then pass that on to our customers. And they've got energy bills themselves to pay, so it is a vicious circle at the moment.
And right now, nobody can say when or how that cycle will end. Chloe Keady, ITV News.
Faith leaders in Leicester have issued a joint statement appealing for calm after weeks of unrest. There was violence in the streets over the weekend amid rising tensions between Hindu and Muslim communities in the city. From Leicester, our Midlands correspondent Ben Chapman reports.
Saturday night in Leicester, and police struggle to contain two large groups trying to attack each other.
Look, again, another one! Wow.
Glass bottles raining down on officers, 16 of them injured. in the culmination of 3 weeks of unrest between young men from sections of the city's Hindu and Muslim communities. Today, leaders from both stood side by side, demanding that it stop.
We together call upon the immediate cessation of provocation and violence, both in thought and behaviour. We together call upon the inciters of hatred to leave our city alone.
Saturday's unrest began when hundreds of masked men marched through a predominantly Muslim area. Video appeared to show them chanting slogans used by Hindu nationalists in India. There have been clashes here since an India versus Pakistan cricket match last month, but the situation has been further inflamed by video appearing to show a flag being torn down at a Hindu temple, an act condemned on all sides. It's happening in a city long renowned for its different faiths living peacefully together. City and community leaders admit they're baffled by the precise cause of the sudden violence, but they say misinformation on social media about extremist elements on both sides is fueling the unrest. Police say they've arrested 47 people, many who are from outside the city.
There will be people that are trying to create that fear and anxiety, and I do firmly believe that some of this spreading of fake news and raising anxiety is organised and it's constructed by people that are going out with that intent.
Police say large numbers of officers on patrol have prevented further violence since the weekend. They say the vast majority of people here don't want it. The test will be whether that message will be heard by the young men on the streets. Ben Chapman, ITV News, Leicester.
A coroner has expressed his deepest sympathies to the family of 14-year-old Molly Russell, who took her own life after viewing online material linked to self-harm and suicide. Social media companies will give evidence during the inquest into her death. Sejal Carrier is at North London Coroner's Court for us this evening. And Sejal, Molly's family hoping for justice at last.
Yes, it's been a five-year-long wait for Molly's family. And they arrived this morning, Ian and Janet, seen here on the right, arriving at the start of the inquest into their daughter's death, knowing it could be a landmark moment for online safety after Molly took her own life in November 2017, aged 14. She'd been viewing online material linked to self-harm, depression and suicide. In the last 6 months of her life, she'd been using her Instagram account up to 120 times a day, liking more than 11,000 pieces of content. And it's thought that she used Pinterest more than 15,000 times during that same period. Now, during the inquest, we'll see representatives of big tech companies being questioned under oath and being asked whether their products may have contributed to the death of a child. Both Meta, which owns Instagram, and separately Pinterest, will be expected to give an account of themselves. Ian, who is Molly's father, believes that long-term exposure to harmful material contributed to her death.
All right, Sejal, thank you. So to come on the ITV Evening News, Wales takes a step closer to a ban on single-use plastics and... how some people living in Windsor got to watch the Queen's coffin procession from their doorstep. Do stay with us. That's after the break. See you then.
Give a warm welcome to the Knit Squad. Relaxed Rachel, Fair Isle Knit. Active Annie, Pointel Jumper. Super Stella, Cable Crew. Killing It, Kate Cardi. Cozy Rosie Roll Neck. The style of your life from £29. Join the Knit Squad at cottontraders.com.
Them or the others. Don't back down, I don't run for cover. I'm a boss, top dog, no time for beginners, only winners. And the crowd goes la, 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 la.
Bold design, innovative technology, impossible to pigeonhole. The award-winning Vauxhall Mokka Electric. Unbox yourself. I'm gonna take you to the future.
At Argos, be restyle ready with our home and furniture range. Argos. Life's here. Be ready. Argos.
Revolut your way into currency exchange. Download Revolut now. Get down, get down, get down, get
down. Get down, get down. It feels good when prices go down. Tesco Mobile will help you spend less on your mobile with Club Card. This is Supermarket Mobile. Get
down. Say hello to Go.Compare, the new way to compare prices on insurance, credit cards and more. So, if you're looking for the right deal on your pet insurance... Oh, looking to switch your home insurance... Or searching for car insurance with £250 free excess cover... Remember, Go.Compare. One click and you're there. Go.Compare!
If you're looking for massive savings, it's a yes from SCS. Yes, you can have this gorgeous sofa for half price at £399. Yes, there's a fabulous saving on this one, now £699. Yes, you'll find up to half price flooring and every carpet's fitted free. Plus, everything's free for a year with 4 years free credit and guaranteed Christmas delivery. Yes, there's a double discount on this sofa, down to only £379. But the saving must end Monday at SCS.
1, 2, 3, 4, 99, 100. Coming! Ready or not?
EasyJet holidays help you find your perfect package holiday from £259 per person. Book now for £1 per person deposit. EasyJet holidays.
Welcome back. Wales has taken another major step closer to banning single-use plastics. A new bill has been brought before the country's parliament, outlawing plastic items including plates, cutlery and lids. Well, it follows growing concerns about the impact they have on the environment. Well, Wales reporter Rhys Williams is in Cardiff tonight. Rhys.
Thanks, Lucrezia. I've actually just spent the last 2 minutes picking some litter up here out in Cardiff Bay outside the St. Ed building. And as you can see, already a reasonable amount of rubbish in this bag. And as you'd expect, so much of it, single-use plastics. I don't think anyone's expecting this bill to mean there'll be less litter on our streets, but perhaps the hope of the Welsh Government is that so much more of it will be recyclable.
It's an all-too-familiar sight across the UK. Single-use plastic items scattered across our parks and beaches. More than 3.5 million tonnes of plastic ends up in landfill every year in the UK. The Welsh Government says today's bill is an attempt to avoid leaving a toxic legacy to future generations.
Plastics are a blight on the environment. I think the will is there, and there are exemptions in the bill for health reasons, for example, for straws. So everyone has been considered in this bill. So I hope as it stands at the moment that it does go through.
Campaigners are understandably happy that Wales has caught up with England and Scotland, who've already banned plastic straws, cotton buds and stirrers. This bill, though, will go further, banning the sale of things like single-use cutlery, balloon sticks and these, single-use carrier bags. Since shops have been required to charge 5p for them, their usage has declined dramatically. But still, more than 500 million are sold in the UK every year.
Best burger line.
For businesses, the proposed changes will have practical implications and likely more cost.
These boxes are very cheap. I buy like 500 for like 12, 13 quid. And I think the other, like the cardboard boxes, they're going to be like 25, 30. and the same quantity, but it's gone up £15-20, and that's your profit margins going.
If passed later this year, the bill will give local councils the powers to enforce the ban, including the right to raid premises. Rhys Williams, ITV News, Cardiff.
Rail unions have announced another national rail strike for Saturday, the 1st of October. Well, Martin Stew, it is King's Cross Station for us tonight. And Martin, this date in particular could cause a lot of problems.
Absolutely. Two different unions, the RMT and ASLEF, both planning that strike action on the same day, Saturday, the 1st of October. In action, they say, could bring the rail network to an effective standstill. Now, it's going to directly impact 16 different rail companies. We're going to put them on screen for you so you can see if yours is impacted. But because Network Rail staff are going on strike as well and they control signalling, to be honest, there is going to be disruption right across the board, and it's unlikely to clear until partway through Sunday, which is a huge headache for the tens of thousands of supporters and runners trying to get to the London Marathon, not to mention people trying to get to the Conservative Party conference. And why is it happening? Well, it's all to do with the ongoing dispute over pay and working conditions. The union want pay to go up in line with inflation. The rail bosses say they can only increase salaries if they can change working conditions. And if that pinch point isn't sorted, there'll be another strike as well on Wednesday, the 5th.
All right, Martin, thank you. Finally, a peak audience of more than 25 million people watched the Queen's funeral on TV yesterday. Tens of thousands more watched the procession in person with huge crowds at Windsor. But some lucky residents got a view all to themselves. Rachel Younger reports.
A new dawn at Buckingham Palace. Flags lowered in national mourning returned to full mast. Streets that played host to princes and presidents swept clean. But the memories are indelible. We now know that 250,000 people personally saw the late Queen lie in state. With 25 million in the UK alone watching yesterday's events unfold on TV. But some found that, quite unexpectedly, the pageantry came to them.
Yesterday was an amazing experience, like a personal show just for us, really.
Simon, who filmed these pictures, lives on the final stretch of road before Windsor's long walk. Although it was packed, the crowds were kept away here. But his family, on the left, were virtually brushed by the bearskins.
They just waited. They were kind of getting ready to go. So they were outside here for about an hour and a half, outside my house, all talking and chatting amongst each other.
Memories of a Queen's last chapter to be handed down to our children's children, just as her crown has passed to a new king. He now has a week of private mourning, today heading for Balmoral, the setting for the previously unseen photograph released by his family in a final tribute to his mother in her favourite place on earth. Rachel Younger, ITV News.
And that is all from us for now. Bye-bye.